Signs all around here reading Black Lives Matter, Black Rights Matter, Black Safety Matters. People of all different ages and ethnicities here participating in this die-in at this hour.
I just graduated from computer science degree. If you guys want help with web development, let me know, man. Let me give you my number. Here. I was with you on Sunday, and you were talking about making action groups and stuff. I can help you with that.
George Floyd, Stephon Clark, Eric Garner, all these peaceful protesters. The mayor's going through the line as well. I had a conversation with the mayor. I believe he supports the resource centers and the ideas that I have that will implement positive effective change that will last generations after you and I have left. So I think you heard me out. I hope he listens to the voice of the people and the voices of Stephon Clark and the voices of George Floyd. Because we want change, we want accountability, we want transparency, and we want justice on all levels. Yeah, that's what we're going to do. Thank you guys for coming.
Thank you so much, sir.
We advocate that. We are nonviolent, peaceful protesters.
Everybody love everybody.
And there you go again. We also heard Ahmaud Arbery, Breonna Taylor, just names again of the different men and women who've been impacted. And who all these folks around us here are hoping to, that the nation will remember, essentially, by demonstrating here. We're going to continue to watch this as this moment here develops, as this demonstration here develops. Perhaps they will have, we will have the answer for you.
If you don't got me on Facebook, Stevante Clark.
Reporting live from
if you don't got me on Instagram, ACR. Official Stevante Clark. Because we fighting for the movement. Y'all hear me?
Starting to disperse. We are working to see if they might be forming another march at this hour. There is a gentleman providing directions over a loudspeaker, over a megaphone.
It
sounds like he's directing on Facebook.
If you're trying to be part of something bigger than yourself,
we're going to figure out if they're planning to march here or if they are all just leaving. But we'll provide you that update as soon as we can.
Blacks are still getting killed while you're protesting. We have to do it foundationally. We got to hold the police accountable for their deployment. It's not a vote. Black lives matter, white lives matter, but black lives are less appreciated. That's why we're here. But your life matters just as much as mine. Okay? If you want to stay here and listen to me, listen, by all means. I am not trying to get you to go away. I don't care if you stay, but I'm passionate about what I'm speaking about.
Yes, sir.
I did my research. I understand the statistical study they have and the reason why the crime rate goes up. So therefore, the police department are getting more funding allocated from the government to keep these poverty stricken communities in control. It's a system, it's a perpetuating system that we can do something about. I respect that you guys are protesting, but what is the protesting for? Once you protest, that is a platform to get something done. What happens from there? We're out here in solidarity. We're out here because we want to see change, but now we're going home. All I'm saying is this, when we use this opportunity, we need to get something done. We need to get something done. This is not about an organization. This is not about a banner. This is not about differences in opinion. This is about unarmed black men getting killed in America. That's why we're here. That's why we're here. We have to do something different. If we're going to come out here in solidarity, we have to have a mission of what we're going to do. What is the objective? Well, I have an objective. I have an objective. The objective is this. We need to have a dialogue with the police department.
Oh, no.
Okay?
No.
We need to have a dialogue with the police department. Okay? All police are not black police. I am not advocating that. But the police in power are allowing the ones to get away with the corruption. You hear me? Please let them decide for themselves.
Fuck the police!
We are not about fucking the police.
Check. 1, 2, 1, 2.
I don't mean to argue, and I usually don't do this. And I even just said I wasn't gonna do this, right? I just said I wasn't gonna argue with a black man in public. But when you talk about a dialogue with murderers, you talking about you that's like telling a woman to go talk to his abuser. You're telling a rape victim to go talk to a rapist. You talk about a dialogue with murderers! They've been killing up.
First off, you got
to first off,
that's what we need to let have family members.
Check.
What if a black man killed a
check,
white
check,
man?
Check. Okay. We have organizations that are black revolutionary. We got people that work with us that are radical throwing brick. We got people that work with us that are in the halls of power trying to change legislation. We got people on every level working on every level because we need people working on every level. We need people of all colors. We talk about people, community, unity. Not these pigs that murder us. I don't get my first cousin's a cop, but it isn't the person. My first cousin's a lovely fucking man, but he works in a racist institution. You understand? Institutional, systemic racism that won't stop because, look, I love my fucking cousin. He's a fucking deputy chief, but he works in a racist institution that kills us. I can't talk to my cousin.